To knit this hat for adult women and teens, I'm going to be using these 16-inch long 4mm knitting needles. We're going to knit the hat in the round. Now you can also use longer needles and just knit the hat in the round using the magic loop technique. And if you want to make it for adult men, I recommend that you use 4.5mm knitting needles instead. Now the yarn that I'm using is this here. It's Lion Brand Touch of Alpaca. This here is a number 4 yarn. You can also use 10 ply or Aran weight yarn. Now, here to begin, the first thing that we need to do is we need to cast on a total of 121 stitches. So to begin here, we need to measure the yarn because I'm going to show you how to cast on your stitches using the long tail cast on. So wrap the yarn around the needle 20 times. That's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Now I have enough yarn for about 20 stitches. Double it up, enough for about 40. Double it up, enough for about 60. Double it up, enough for about 80. Double it up, enough for about 100. I need 121, so we're going to double it up again. That's enough for about 120 stitches. I'm going to add a little bit more. It's best to have some leftover than to have to do this again. So now here, make a slip knot and insert your needle here through this slip knot. Now this is the yarn that we just measured, and this here is coming from the skein. Now open the yarn like this. We're going to go from left to right, and we're going to grab a loop like this. That's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and so on until you have 121 stitches. Continue. I'll meet you once this part here is done to show you what we need to do next. Okay, I finished casting on my stitches. I have a total of 121 stitches. Make sure that your stitches here are not twisted. Make sure that they all face the same direction. Now, with the working yarn on the right hand, we're going to go here into the first stitch and bring this first stitch to the right needle. Now, bring the last stitch that you cast on over the first stitch, or this stitch that we have here on this needle, and drop that stitch. Now pull this yarn. Now we're joined in the round. Now I have 120 stitches. So with these stitches, now we're going to work the brim. So here we're going to knit one, purl one, knit one, purl one, all around. So beginning with this next stitch, knit one. The next one, purl one, knit one, purl one, knit one, purl one. And this is all I'm going to do all around for this first row, knit one, purl one. Now I forgot to put a stitch marker here to mark the beginning, but I'm going to do that at the end of this row. Continue. I will meet you at the end of this first row. I'm here at the end of the first row. This is where I knit and purl. My last stitch here is a purl. I'm going to place a stitch marker. So now from here on, we're going to repeat the same thing. We're going to knit the first stitch and purl the next. Knit one, purl one. Knit one, purl one. And that's all we're going to do. Knit one, purl one. Now continue like this all around for a total of 20 rows. At the end of the 20th row, I'm going to add an extra stitch. So I will meet you at the end of that row to show you how we're going to make that increase and then continue with the pattern. I'm here at the end of the 20th row. I still have one last stitch. Here I want to show you that at the end of this row, I'm going to add one extra stitch. So I have one stitch left here to complete the 20th row. So to add this extra stitch, or to make one, I'm going to bring this bar that's in between this stitch and the last one. So all you're going to do is just lift this up, put it on the needle like this and knit through the back. This is going to be my extra stitch so that at the end of this 20th row of the brim, I have 121 stitches. Now purl the last stitch, and here is the 20th row with a total of 121 stitches, which is divisible by 11. I need this part here to now be in multiples of 11 so that I can start my cable pattern. But before we do that, I'm going to make one more row where I just knit all around. That way all of my stitches are facing in the same direction. So continue. Make this row where you just knit all around. At the end of this row, you're going to have 121 stitches. I will meet you at the end of this row. I finished this row where I knit all around. I have a total of 121 stitches. Now we're going to start our cable pattern. This is the stitch that we're going to do here. This hat here was knit in rows. So if you prefer to knit your hat in rows where you seam at the end, then I already have a tutorial for this. I'll leave it up here or in the information box below. I'll leave that link. So the stitch pattern that I'm going to use is the cable stitch. So to start here, I'm going to purl two, knit one, purl two. Now the next six stitches here is going to be one of the cables. So I'm going to remove the next three stitches like this, pass this through the back, and knit three. Bring back the stitches that we removed to the left needle and knit three. Now this is going to create the first twist for this first cable. That's one, two, and three. There, here's the twist. Now the next five stitches, purl two, knit one, purl two. Again, for the next six stitches, we're going to make the second cable, remove these three stitches, put them to the back, and knit the next three stitches. Now bring the three stitches that we removed back to the left needle and knit these three stitches. One, two, three. There. Here's the second cable, and there's that twist. Now the next five stitches, this is what separates the cables. You purl two, knit one, purl two, and then repeat the same thing. For the next six stitches, remove three, put them to the back, and knit three. One, two, three. Bring back the three stitches that we removed. And knit three. There. And that's how you're going to continue. The next five stitches, purl two, knit one, purl two. And here you're going to repeat the fourth cable. Now continue like this all around. Finish this first row to this first repeat. I'll be calling these repeats. This is where we repeat six rows. The first row is where you twist, and then you continue with 5 rows, and then you repeat rows 1 through 6 again. So I'll be calling those repeats. You can also call them sets. I'm going to be doing a total of, 10 sets. I think that's how many I did for this hat. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yes, 10 or 11, I think. So that's how you're going to continue. I'll meet you at the end of this first row for this first repeat. I'm here at the end of this first row to the first repeat. This is where we do the cables. Now I have a total of 11 cables. Now for the second row, this is what we're going to do. We're going to start with purl two, knit one, purl two. Now these 5 stitches that are in between the cables, this part here never changes. You always purl two, knit one, purl two. Now we have the 6 stitches for the first cable. You just knit 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now the next 5 stitches, purl 2, knit 1, purl 2. And then again, we have the next 6 stitches for the second cable, knit 6. That's all we're going to do for this second row. Continue like this to the end of this second row. I finished the second row. Now for rows 3, 4, 5, and 6, you're just going to repeat the same thing. Purl 2, knit 1, purl 2, and knit 6. Again, purl 2, knit 1, purl 2, knit 6. And that's all you're going to do here for rows 3, 4, 5, and 6. I will meet you at the end of the 6th row. I finished making these 6 rows. Remember, the first row is where we do the twist, and then we make 5 more rows for a total of 6 rows here for the repeats. Now we're going to repeat these 6 rows again for the second repeat. So to start you off here, we're going to purl 2, knit 1, purl 2. Now we have the first cable. This is where we're going to do the second twist. Remove these 3 stitches here. Put them to the back here. Knit 3. Now bring back these 3 stitches to the left needle. There. And now knit 3. And here is the second twist for this cable right there. Now, the stitches in between always remain the same. These 5 stitches, we always purl 2, knit 1, purl 2. And then again, we have the second cable. Remove the next 3 stitches. Put them to the back. Knit 3, bring back the 3 stitches that you removed to the left needle, and knit 3. There. And that's all you're going to do here for the rest of this first row to the second repeat. Continue, I'll meet you at the end to show you what we need to do next. I finished the first row for the second repeat. This is where we did the second twist here for our cable stitch. Now for the next 5 rows, so row 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, this is all you're going to do. You're going to purl 2, knit 1, purl 2. And then for the cable here, the 6 stitches, you just knit 6. And that's all you're going to do for the next 5 rows, row 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Continue, I will meet you at the end of the 6th row. I finished making the second repeat. I completed these 6 rows. In the first row, remember we do the twist and then continue on for another 5 rows, so in total 6 rows here. So now we're going to start the third repeat, and same thing, I'm just going to start you off here with this first row where we do the twist, and then you're going to continue on. Now here to begin, we purl 2, knit 1, purl 2, and then we have the first cable, we remove 3 stitches, put it towards the back, knit 3, bring the 3 stitches back to the left needle, and knit. One, two, and 3. There, here's the third twist for the first cable, and then the stitches in between these 5 stitches, you purl 2, knit 1, purl 2, and then continue on with the second cable. This is how we're going to continue repeating these 6 rows. I'm not sure how many rows I'm going to do here or how many twists I'm going to do, but continue watching. I will let you know exactly how many rows I'm going to do or how many repeats I'm going to do, so I will meet you at the end of that row. I'm almost done with the hat. I did a total of 9 complete repeats. For the 10th repeat, I only did 2 rows, the first and the second row. Now what we're going to do is just start the decreasing part so that we can finish the hat. So to do this here, I have, let's see, the stitches to separate the cables, the 5 stitches. So I'm going to purl 2 together. Now there is no right or wrong way of doing this. This is how I'm going to do it. The important thing here is just to decrease and then just close the top of the hat. The next stitch here, I'm going to knit. I'm going to keep this center stitch here in the same way. Now I'm going to purl 2 together, and now we have the stitches here for the cable. I'm going to knit 3 together, so knit 3 together there, and then knit 3 together for the next 3 there. And then again, repeat, purl 2 together, knit 1, purl 2 together, and then we have the cable, knit 3 together, knit 3 together, and then repeat, purl 2 together, knit 1, purl 2 together, and that's how I'm going to decrease all around. Continue for this row, I'll meet you at the end. I'm here at the end of this first row of decreases. I have a total of 55 stitches here all around. Now for the second row here, we are going to purl 1, knit 1, purl 1, and then the cable row here, knit 2 together. Again, purl 1, knit 1, purl 1, knit 2 together. And that's all I'm going to do here for the second row. Continue, I'll meet you at the end. I'm here at the end of the second row of decreases. I have 44 stitches. Now I'm going to cut my yarn here. I'm not going to continue anymore with the decreases. So I'm just going to cut my yarn, and I'm going to use one of these yarn needles, and I'm going to now remove all of these stitches here. You can continue, make one more of decreases if you like. As it is, I think it's fine. With 44 stitches left, we should be able to close the hat. So just remove all of the stitches. Okay, here's the last stitch. Now hold on to this loop here. When you pull all the way, just don't let go of this loop. We're going to insert the needle through this loop like this so that it creates a knot there. And now we can pull all the way. There. Perfect. And that's how it looks here at the top. I'm going to remove this stitch marker here. Now insert the needle here through the center again and go on the inside and just weave this end here all around. There is no right or wrong way of doing this. I like to just go all around like this through the same stitches that we removed in the last row here. Just go all around to close this hole. Make sure you pull. See how that hole there is closing as you weave this all around. Okay, there, I think that's fine. I'm just going to go through here on the inside in and out to the side to make a knot. And then you can make one more knot. Go through the center and come out here to the side. And make a knot. There. Let's see how it looks here. Perfect. Here's the top. Now we can cut our yarn. Turn it over. And the hat is finished. Here's the top. That's how it looks. I think that looks pretty good. And the hat is done. Look how beautiful that looks. I'm going to put a pompon on mine. These beautiful pompons. I purchased these from Amazon. Look how beautiful that looks. So our hat is done, and I love the way that this fits on me. It's perfect for adult women. Now for men, I would recommend that you use a slightly bigger kneading needle size, like 4.5 millimeter kneading needles instead of 4 millimeter like we used. That way it comes out slightly bigger. Now this was today's tutorial. I hope you like it. Don't forget, if you prefer a written pattern, check out my Etsy shop. Thanks for watching.